Good morning. Here is today's word of blessings for you. Philippians 4:10-13. I rejoiced greatly in the Lord that at last you renewed your concern for me. Indeed, you were concerned, but you had no opportunity to show it. I am not saying this because I am in need, for I have learned to be content whatever the circumstances. I know what it is to be in need, and I know what it is to have plenty. I have learned the secret of being content in any and every situation, whether well fed or hungry, whether living in plenty or in want. I can do all this through Him who gives me strength. Today's title is I Can Do All Things Through Him. Years ago, I had an opportunity to take a trip to Asia Minor with several members of my church. It was a sort of pilgrimage for us. We took a car and followed the ancient route of Paul's missionary trip from Asia Minor to Europe. We visited several ancient cities such as Ephesus, Athens, and Corinth. We went to the sites of several ancient churches. Even though we went to the places after 2,000 years and we barely saw the vestige of the ancient cities and churches, the trip gave us unforgettable insights into what Apostle Paul might have gone through. It was a long and difficult journey even with cars. We can imagine how difficult and hard it must have been to Paul. We could understand what Paul said much better. He said, I have worked much harder, been in prison more frequently, been flogged more severely, and been exposed to death again and again. 5 times I received from the Jews the 40 lashes -1. 3 times I was beaten with rods, once I was pelted with stones, 3 times I was shipwrecked, I spent a night and a day in the open sea, and I have been constantly on the move. I have been in danger from rivers, in danger from bandits, in danger from my fellow Jews, in danger from Gentiles, in danger in the city, in danger in the country, in danger at sea, and in danger from false believers. 2 Corinthians 11:23-26, preaching the gospel in such challenging and even hostile places must have required a daring spirit. How could he do it? I believe we can find the answer in today's passage. I can do all this through Him who gives me strength. He could do it only through Him who gave him strength. And he did it well. And I believe that it was not only Paul's journey but the journey of us all on earth. There are so many ups and downs, mountains and valleys in our lives. How could we pass through all of such intimidating and perilous places and finally reach our heavenly home? Your answer is the same as Paul's. I can do all this through Him who gives me strength. Do you have a daring spirit and faith in your heart?